What is up people, it's Tom with Satori Graphics, back again with another graphic design tips video. Today, I'm going to show you three Adobe Illustrator tools that I think you either do not use, or you don't use them that often. I feel these tools are very underrated in Adobe Illustrator. I'm going to show you how to use them in your graphic design workflow. If you haven't done already, subscribe for 4 weekly graphic design uploads, and remember to like and share my content if you do find it useful. The first Illustrator tool you must be using for graphic design is super handy and helpful for things like logo designing. Let's take a look at these circles I've arranged here, and let's say for my logo I want to make a shape out of this section here. Commonly, people will use the Pathfinder tool to cut or create shapes using other shapes. However, in this instance, this function is not going to work, as you're going to see now. So instead, with your shape selected, come over to the Shape Builder tool. You then literally just have to draw within the areas of the shape you want to create. Once you've done that, hold down the Alt Option key until you see the minus icon, and then draw over the areas that you don't want. You can make so many intricate and interesting shapes with this tool. Shapes you cannot make with the Pathfinder tool, and shapes that would take time and hassle to make with a pen tool. So for that reason alone, this is an Illustrator tool that you must be using for graphic design. The next Illustrator tool that you must be using for graphic design helps you locate and select shapes of the same color, stroke, gradient style, and opacity. This helps vastly when you have a complicated and busy design. So let's say I want to select every single circle of a single color in my line design here. We will be using the Magic Wand tool to do so. Many people associate the Magic Wand tool with Photoshop only, but trust me, it's very useful in Illustrator too. You need to open up the Magic Wand window here, first and foremost. Let's have a closer look at the Magic Wand window. You can choose to select objects by fill color, stroke weight, the opacity, and the blend mode. For this example, I'm going to show you the fill color. Bring down the tolerance all the way down to 1, so it's super accurate with the color it selects. Now grab the Magic Wand tool and select the object you want. As you can see, it selected the pink circle and every single part of the design that is that color. Now we can go back and edit every single shape. This Illustrator tool is a must because when you have complicated designs, you can save time by selecting certain aspects of that design. The last Illustrator tool that you must be using for graphic design will allow you to overlay a pattern or a texture onto another aspect of the design. I want to overlay this pattern on the right here, over the top of the circle on the left. So hit Command or Control C to copy the pattern, or whatever you want to overlay. And then with the other part of the design highlighted, open up the transparency window. We want to click Make Mask, uncheck Clip, and then select the right window in the transparency window. You then hit Command or Control V to paste it in place. Resize and position it, and then as you can see here, that looks pretty cool. We can even add our new design over the top of a circle of the same size, and then add a color or a gradient fill. By the way, you can find vector patterns for free quite easily on Google. Just search something like free vector patterns and lots of searches will pop up. So here I'm changing the pattern layer with a gradient overlay and adjusting the gradient style. You can experiment with this and have some fun doing so. This Illustrator tool is great for many aspects of graphic design, but I'm currently designing a speaker vector for a client, and I've used this tool as part of the speaker. So, do you agree with my list of Illustrator tools you must be using for graphic design? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, check out my ebook by clicking the card in the top right corner. It's a beginner guide to typography with terminologies and tips. Like and share my content if you do enjoy coming here to Satori Graphics, and subscribe for 4 weekly graphic design uploads. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.